What's going on, guys? Got four people in here all ready to get things started. We got Missouri Live Outdoors, who is a YouTube auditor. Ted, Rich, and Leo. CBA was in here. We got a lot of noise from a lot of waves coming in from pleasure boaters. I don't know if I was supposed to point that out, but only a few other people know it. How about that? But yeah, they're coming in close. You know, I mean, look at this jackass. You know, they're right here. Thanks, ass. Oh, man. Don't know how we're going to do, but we're trying. Found a spot that I got good shade. The tree issue kind of sucks. I have to walk out into the water to go cast, but that's all right. I got me some water shoes. I got cut carp and some bluegill out on the hook. Let's see what else. I got good shade. I'm out on a point. Took me half an hour to drive from the first spot I was going to try to get over here. It was a pain in the ass, but... Rich Jarvis, NJ, what's going on? Yeah, I got 4-ounce sinkers on there. I went to cast my second Uncle Lou's rod, and the freaking thing backlashed, and the line ended up snapping, so I pulled my spare rod out of the truck. Figured I'd only throw 3 out right now, being such a tight area. What's up, Daniel? Up to 14 people already. Thank you for coming in. I appreciate it. But I got to fix that backlash here in a few minutes. I haven't messed with it. Yeah, NJ's got him a carp challenge going on tomorrow. But this lake is just packed full of pleasure boaters. And it is a big, big lake. What's up, Bandit? How you doing? Why do you think I'll be rooting for Yak Shore? I like both of you guys. It's hard to root for either one of you. Or hard to not root for either one of you, I meant. Bonus points if I catch a boat. Well, it's possible. I don't know that it's too deep out here where I'm at. But I had to kind of do a little off-roading to get here. This area is an old shut-down campground. The road's still here, but the trees are all overgrown. There's a lot of ups and downs and rocks I had to go over. Steve Loke in the house. What's going on, man? Thanks for coming in, sir. I had my baits in the water for... I think I got him in the water right after I scheduled this, or maybe right before. I don't know if all these boats are going to keep fish away or not. Otter Cat, what's going on? Johnny Small Pepper in the house. piggy in the house too. What kind of catch am I, or where I'm fishing? I don't know. I think there's all three of the major food groups in here. That's all right, Piggy. I appreciate you coming in. Stay as long as you can. Take your nap. YouTube auditor would know the answer to that. He used to fish this lake, or a lot. There's so many areas on this lake to fish, and I don't know. I thought, what the hell, this is a point. I try it. One of the areas is called Moonshine Beach, and that area is so packed that there was about a 10 to 20 car line on the shoulder of the road just to pull into that area. They've got somebody at the entry stopping everybody. But it only took me, the first area I went to, I think it only took me about 45 minutes to get there. It's really not bad. So I think I will be coming down here more. I got cut carp and bluegill. Cut bluegill. Not really an easy thing to try to keep the bluegill alive in the motel room. So it's just throw them on ice, put them in the freezer. Use them as cut bait. Got a big old V8 boat coming through. Good Lord, look at this sucker. Be nice to have that thing. Have some fun. Much as like fishing, I still love the pleasure part of getting out on the lake on the water. Ted Bundy. NJ got nicknamed for everybody. I see trail dust in the house. Hey, what's going on, Trail Desk? How you doing, man? Glad you stumbled in here. Hopefully I can stumble into a fish. Not sure if blue cats are in Table Rock. So probably channel cats, maybe some flatheads. We're up to 16 wonderful people in here. I appreciate you so much for coming in, taking time on your Saturday to come hang out. I didn't get to go home this weekend. I've got to help the mechanic work on the crane again tomorrow. So, I stayed up here. Plus, it cost me $200 every weekend in gas just to drive home and back. For a friggin' 3.5 hour drive. How about that? Looks cooler than the last time. It is definitely cooler, which now, I mean, it's actually, temperature-wise, it's not any cooler than the last live I did. It is 96 degrees, but I am under, I think, a big cypress tree, and I've got shade trees all around me. I pulled the truck up in here, I unloaded, and I'm set up off the edge of the water. Pretty sure it's cypress tree. We've got all these little cypress nubs down in the ground coming up all over. So that's what I figure it is. Yep. Thanks to turn people out. For you guys who aren't familiar with Trail Dust, he's one of the guys I know from the blacksmithing community. Lives that I hang out in. He's a pretty cool cat. I guess he likes some fishing because he comes in and hangs out in my live sometimes. I hope you guys are able to hear me. over that water. Because the water is pretty loud on my end. Ah. Table Rock has big blues. Well, be nice if I catch a big blue. So yeah, if you guys are into any kind of metal art or blacksmithing or metal working, Trail Dust, he does some stuff. You got Island, Island Metal Forge, I think. Yamez. Christ-Centered Iron Works. Black Bear Forge. There's a lot of good channels out there on that end. D. Baca Maker. A lot of good people. Got a lot of good people in here in the catfishing community, too. I have so much trouble catching catfish, I might as well take up carp fishing. Maybe then I'll have some, I can give NJ some competition. Yeah, I'm staying cool in the shade. We got a nice breeze going on. And I figure I will crack me an adult beverage sitting back here. Brought me some Yingling. Only brought what I had left in the room. I didn't stop and buy anything. Yeah, Richard Jarvis, Rich and Leo, they're from our UK side. They are some British fishermen. Rich and Leo, Leo is his son. The legend. They get out and do a lot of fishing. We got several people from Australia as well. The sandy toes, all that fluffing stuff. Carping down under. We got our South African buddy, Pete's Whiskers. He catches those South African catfish. He got some interesting catfish down there. What's up, CBA? CBA, I don't know if you saw the comment earlier, but I appreciate the birthday beer on you. I went ahead and used that to buy myself one last night. Thanks, NJ. I hope I catch something. Trail Dust fabrication 50 years ago. Now it tries to save on the wear and tear. Kind of hard to do once the wear and tear has already started. My knees are already feeling it from pounding the pavement, working on equipment for so many years. Physical labor. I got out of working on equipment. When I got laid off, I said, screw it. I already had my operating engineer's book. So I said, yep, I'm not buying a rig. I'm not going to be a field mechanic or anything. Screw it. I'm going out to operate equipment. More fun. So that's what I do now. What's up, Chris Edward? How you doing, brother? Thank you for coming in. We got a good 15-person crowd going on. Been up to 18. I know there are other channels going live. I know Mr. Epic and Sean, they're out there busting it. Last time I saw, they had 80-something people in there. I can't compete. But, you know, it's my chance to get out here and try another new body of water. And hopefully catch some fish. What's up, Danny Stone? This the Crippled Catfisherman's Club? I don't know. Who's crippled? I mean, I'm not there yet. I just can't squat down for more than a couple seconds at a time because my knees are not good. I mean, they don't hurt me when I walk and do stuff, but I cannot crouch down. It's my turn. Yeah, I went in there and watched for a while I was driving, heading down here. But, like I said, when I plan on going live, I'll go in and I'll watch lives, but I won't go in and chat. I won't tell people I'm going live. I mean, I won't go in the live and say, hey, I'm going live. You know, that's not my thing. Unless my live is scheduled for hours later or something. Fat Magnet Guy in the house? Hey, what's going on, Fat Magnet Guy? How you doing? Watched some of your videos recently. You getting out there, grabbing you some things on your magnet. Yeah, Danny, I was in your live. Well, you know that. I was in your live while you were driving back. I ended up having to worry about driving. Uh-oh. Are we getting a bite, or is that waves? I got waves. They just keep coming. Relentless. Yep, you guys, Fat Magnet Guy. I go into some magnet fishing channels. Fat Magnet Guy, Iron Antlers. Dirty Magyackers, he fishes from kayak, does magnet fishing, does metal. I think he does a whole lot of stuff. There's a variety of people. Kind of bounce around a lot of different communities. But hello, Miss Froggy. That's all right, Froggy. I'll be here for a while. And if I'm not here, I'll be moving and finding another location. Yeah, well, the problem is you got people out here on this lake that, you know, they want to run 75 feet off the damn bank and don't pay attention, which, yeah, they don't see me back here until they actually look over, because I am tucked back in the trees pretty good, as you can see. Yeah, you guys ever get interested in magnet fishing? There's a whole magnet fishing community. And something kind of neat. You get out there, throw your magnet. You never know what you'll find in the body of water, whether it be a creek, river, lake, off of a fishing dock. Hell, you might pull up some bait knives, clean them up, and be able to use them. Superb with or without the shirt. Branson Bell come by. Yeah, I drove by the place. Yeah, no, I don't think I'm going to have any trouble with the phone overheating. Yeah, I am in the shade. I said it is hot, but I really don't feel the heat down here in the shade and the wind. So that does make it nice. It damn sure a hell of a lot better than the last live. Or the one with Uncle Josh. That was, yeah, after he left and I moved, God, that was excruciating. I need to go grab my Uncle Lou's rod real quick and start working on fixing that backlash. And when it backlashed, the line ended up breaking somewhere on the spool. But yeah. Not horrible, but yeah, somewhere along the line it ended up breaking. So. Need to try to get that taken out of there. All right, Froggy. Be here. Hunky Bunny. That's a new one. So So I went into Academy last night and walked around. I had to get out of the room, go eat some dinner, you know, get out. And so I go into Academy and I look around. And Academy here, Walmart here in Missouri is totally different than Oklahoma. Now, Missouri has a lot of fly fishing. They've got trout and everything. So they've got a trout fishing section and a fly fishing section in Walmart. What up, Jeremy? How you doing, brother? Now, we don't have any kind of fly fishing section at Walmart. But theirs do here. But when I was in Academy, I was looking, and they sell a Shimano catfishing rod. I guess it's catfishing rod. It is a 9-foot. Now, all I saw was a spinning rod. I can't remember the model of it, but it's a 9-foot spinning rod, and it's only $50. It's two-piece. Not a backlash. It's professional overrun. Never heard that one. But I think before I end up leaving here, and you know, I'm not that great with my spinning rod. Maybe it's the reel itself. I don't know. I just never can get casting it down very good. But I think before I end up leaving up here, leaving Missouri, I'm going to go in there to Academy and go get one of those Shimano rods. Because for $50 for a 9-foot rod, you know, that's not a bad deal. I think it holds, it says 20 to 30-pound line. It doesn't say anything about lure size. That's kind of weird because most of the time you do see a rod saying their lure, you know, what size lure to use. But, yeah, I got the backlash out, by the way. It wasn't too hard. Now I got to get the line out of the rod. But, you know, be good to have for fishing off the bank. Have a longer rod. Get a little more distance out there. Danny said I can't grow a beard worth a lick. Oh, look at Jeremy. Yeah, Jeremy Dirt over there. Trying to throw smoke. That's the first time I think I've ever said that, made that comment, said that term. Jeremy trying to throw smoke about growing beards. Come on, we've all seen Jeremy's beard. All right. Now we got that. Luckily, this pin reel holds quite a bit of line. Uh-oh. Now, the thing I hate about what just happened is the level line guide is on the wrong side of the reel, or wrong side of the spool, as opposed to where my line is. I guess I got to figure out how I'm going to fix that. Problem is, I don't know. Oh, I think I figure out. I'll just keep pulling line off. I'll pull line off by hand without spooling the reel or moving the spool, and I'll get it over to the right side. That's about the only thing I can think to do. Because if the line isn't in line with the line guide, ain't exactly gonna help. That's gotta take several wraps off of it. Just get it there. Uh-oh. Really? Come on, fishy, let's get a fish. Need a fish. Come along and take my bait. This is easier said than done, by the way. Still got 11 people hanging out. Trying to watch the rods as I do this. And watch the chat. Out. Lord. I don't know how much line I'm going to have to pull off this damn thing just to get it back in order. What's up, Ace? How you doing, bud? We're posted up in the shade with baits in the water. That's about all we can say right now. All I got going on right now. Thank you, Richard. I appreciate it. I try to give my support to as many people as I can. Not financially so much. Not really financially, but just by being part of people's channel. Trying to help them grow in some way and just be there to be a friend. Come on, fish. All right, I almost got my line in line with the line guide. And one thing I found about this pinreel that I don't particularly care for is the line guide does not spool the line all the way to the edge of the spool. So I'll end up with kind of the bulk of my line in the middle. I mean, it does go off to the side of the sides. It doesn't evenly run. All right, Biggie, go have a good nap. Hope your head feels better when you get back or when you get up. Hopefully I'll catch something. We're going to try. Stay here for a couple hours. Don't have any luck. Then I'll look on Google Maps and I'll try to find somewhere different. One spot I wanted to go to that a helper, a YouTube auditor was trying to help me get to. I went there. And they had the gate closed. So I was unable to go there and fish. Good Lord. Well, think about I about got my line caught up with the level wine. Now the problem is, now the thing is, get this big old bundle of line that I've got here back in order. I can run it through there without bird nesting again, without casting. Thank you, Richard. Yep, you never know who's lurking. All right, there we go. Now maybe this will help me. Now wrap the line around the reel and holding it. That way it doesn't get slack on the spool. You know, this fishing stuff's a pain in the butt. What's up, Warren Farley? How you doing? Thanks for hanging out. You can lurk. You don't have to chat. Not everybody's a chatter. I myself am a chatter. Sometimes I do lurk, though. I think I'm getting this whole thing figured out. Back. Keep my line. Oh. Good thing this is only a 7'6" rod. I can stand up and reach the last eye. But if it was 8 foot, don't see that I'd be reaching that last eye without having to tilt it over. All right. Now where are we at? Okay, now I can sit back down. Here, fishy, fishy, fishy. Folding your laundry with your phone on the floor. That's cool. I'm going to have to do my laundry at some point this weekend. All right, there we go. Now I just got to get what I got wrapped around the reel here. And we're good. I can reel up all the excess. Get this thing tied, retied. Eventually, end up sending it out. Take that Zebco rod off the rack there. And send old Uncle Lou's rod back out. Might need some chicken. Yeah, after catching that largemouth on chicken that last time, that was crazy. I couldn't believe that happened. Never caught a bass on chicken before. All right. Got my reel situated. tighten my drag back up. Spool this stuff back up. Then I've got to pick up my line that ended up breaking off. Tie the rig back on. But we're back in business. Now I probably lost 75 feet of line off of there. Where's my pocket knife? All right, I got it. Yeah, this might end up being a couple segment live tonight, today. What's up, Kenneth? How you doing? Thank you for coming in, sir. How'd the one-on-one go last night between Daryl and Stan? Win them. They were last night. I'd still like to find out why Hogleg unmodded me in his channel. Melissa noticed that one night and she was like, "Hey, Hogleg, Dan doesn't have a wrench. Give him his wrench back." And ain't done that yet, so. Oh well. Yeah, I don't need a wrench in the channel. But to lose it when I don't know why, you know, that sucks. I have no idea if I did anything to piss Hogleg off or anything else. Stan was winning, then Daryl stormed ahead. A dozen one-pound channel cats. Yeah, when I was watching early on, I just kept hearing Daryl, "Fish on, fish on, fish on." Starting to sound like Brian B. "Fish on, fish on. Dink on." See, I don't get to say it that much, so. You guys hear me say, "Oh shit, fish." I get excited. I don't catch fish that often, but when I do, I get excited. All right, Kenneth. Hey, y'all talk on a regular. You might be able to find a reason why. Or who knows, maybe somebody I pissed off convinced them to take it away. Who knows? There are people that get swayed like that. Full blown country, what's going on, Pooch? How you doing? Hey, Chris, thanks, sir. I need some luck. I got the water. I got the bait. I got the breeze and the shade. All I need is the fish. Oh, and I got a good crowd, too. Got a good crowd behind me. I hope you're not working too hard, Pooch. Yeah, I don't know, Jeremy. I was in your live that night, Jeremy, that you got pissed when Lynn timed Jody out, and then you just ended your live. You know, understandable. You took wrenches away. I wasn't gonna bother me. I was there to see and know what was going on, but it's just weird. Yeah, like I said, printing shirts. You should have been doing last night. Yeah, last night I got out. I went to Academy, walked around, went to Texas Roadhouse, had me a 12-ounce ribeye dinner, which I don't even know that I really had the appetite to eat half of my meal. Drank my beer. Then I went to the bar, and it was college night. And it was full of hot women dressed in crop tops and, you know, scantily clad. Girls definitely dress different now than they did when I was 21 in my early 20s. You know, it was nice. There was a lot of eye candy there, but none of them girls want a dad, want a guy that's old enough to be their dad or twice their age. You know, fun for a night, but, you know. Randy, what's going on, Mr. Randall Rhino? How you doing, brother? Hope Tammy's doing all right after her treatment. Hey, NJ, I can make you some shirts. I'm a whiz with a Sharpie. I know how to write a big old NJ with some fish hooks on the shirt. I'll even buy different colors. All right, Richard, have a good night. Thanks for coming in and hanging out, trying to help out. You know what I did when I went home? Yeah, I hung out in Mike's Fishing Homes live and laid there on the bed and ended up falling asleep. Oh, yeah. Now, I get you, Jeremy. I know. I was never part of that. I never timed people out just for fun. Thought it was stupid. You know, time somebody out, that deletes every comment they said. Then they don't get to chat for 5 minutes. Yeah, and unless they're cussing heavy, you know, dropping porn, stuff like that. Yeah, being a real tool. Now, I hear you. Like I've said many times, I don't mind if somebody cusses a little bit. I mean, hell, I say shit all the time. You know, if somebody's not just every last word, if it's in the middle of their sentence that they type out, you know, it ain't gonna hurt nothing. I ain't gonna care. Dan makes some pretty good anchors. That's good to hear, Randy. I'm happy to hear that. NJ, I think I saw you time somebody out not too long ago, didn't I? Trying to catch up with Chad here. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, the timing out for fun thing, it's ridiculous. Oh yeah. Well, yeah, you time out people, you can end up losing subs. Damn, those waves are rolling. They about to make it all the way up here to me. Y'all gonna see me swimming before long. Yeah, I think I was there. I think I saw that, NJ. 351, what's going on, buddy? Appreciate you coming in. Yeah, I was never part of the time out for fun revolution, and I don't think I ever really got timed out for fun either. So, I mean, I have by, you know, Sunfish King, he'll time me out when I make a joke about his girlfriend. A simple minor joke, you know, not like of the adult kind or rude. But yeah, he does that for fun. Earl, Reef Robber, he's timed me out a couple times for fun. But you know, it's his channel and I know he was doing it for fun. Because I can always text Earl when he does it. I don't have to chat in the live to get to him. I just text him. Love old Earl. I'll make my way out there to Oregon and go do some sea fishing and some crabbing with him. When I get done with this job, hopefully I'll have the money in the bank. I can do that. Shannon says, hi, she's doing dishes. Hey, Randy, what's going on? Tell Shannon hi. Yep, I tell Earl he's number one. I timed you out on accident. My bad, CBA. My bad, dog. Yeah, I'm finally getting this thing tied back up where I can cast it back out when I'm ready. I'm pissed because I lost my bluegill head. I had a good-sized bluegill head on there. And I don't know if, you know, the clamshells, if having clamshells washed up on the beach all over the place is a sign that maybe fish are around, or maybe it's a good place for fish. But there's a million clamshells washed up over here. Probably from when the water's been high. Oh yeah, Chris. I have a lot of good people that come into my channel and my lives. And I really appreciate everybody that does. Never have any trouble, never have any drama. I'm not into the drama. You know, you get those people that are, oh, I'm not going to be friends with you because you're supporting or you're friends with the person that I don't like. Well, you know what? I don't base my life off of what you do. I don't base my life off of your life. And you don't base your life off of mine. So why the hell does it matter? If I'm friends with somebody else, that don't affect your life. Know what I mean? We're up to 20 people. How about that? Once again, I want to thank each and every one of you guys. Taking the time out of your Saturday to come hang out with me. And I'm going to wind up my line. Can't we all just get along? Probably not. Nope. Yeah, you know, we're in a world where not everybody's going to get along. But And if you can't get along with people, then don't be around them. Don't associate with them. Know what I mean? Yes, sir, Randy. I like and support who I choose. Yep. Yeah, just like all the drama that was happening not too long ago, you know. I wasn't part of it. Little girls are everywhere, and they're 50-year-old men, not little girls. Yeah. Yeah, you had a blast on Mike's last night. I didn't get to hang out all that long. I am at 3,200 watch hours. I just topped 3,200 with my birthday live. So, yeah. I'm most of the way there on my hours. I'm still lacking over 450 subs, but you know what? I'm not in any rush. I'll get there. If I get there. If I don't, I don't. I just continue doing my thing and enjoying my time. Enjoying the people that enjoy the time with me. Lynn J, I hope you get on some carp tomorrow. I know exactly how you feel with the skunks. Yeah, I remember, Lynn J, when I first found you, I remember seeing you were already in the 600 range. And then you found the community and you jumped up pretty quick. Yeah. For a lifetime, I'm over 3,500 hours. For my 365 day hours, I'm at 3,200. So not too bad. I'm trying to keep it up. I'm trying to do lives and keep that up. I was at 546 subs the other day. Then I dropped down to 544. And then yesterday I was back up to 546. And then I dropped back to 544 again. So, you know. Happy birthday, Randy. Hey, Randy, happy birthday. Did not know it was your birthday. Yeah, I don't know how to edit video yet, so yeah. I'm stuck doing the live stream thing. You know, a lot of people that get monetized just from their videos and stuff, they might think it's a way of cheating. I don't know, I just look at it as though that's how I'm growing, and that's how it's working, so, you know. Problem is, I only do 3-hour lives and need to do 9. Well, NJ, you get pretty good crowds come in. You do it at a good time of day when people, you know, mornings, there's always there's a good crowd that always comes in, and especially since Lee Evans is taking a little break. Got to be up here. Hey, Shannon, done doing dishes. Yeah, the water does look beautiful. It feels good. Having to walk out there and cast up. Oh, yeah, Jeremy. Now, are you saying click as in group click? If so, yeah, there's a lot of that. there's a lot of that in this catfish community thing, and you know, people say there's not, but all you got to do is sit back and watch. You know, I'm friends with everybody for the most part, but do I fit in with everybody's group? No, not really. What's up, Kelly? I've been doing this for almost a year and a half now. You know, you don't see me catching fish, so, or giving away all kinds of free stuff or anything, so you don't see me on talk shows getting interviewed or anything else. Year, every single one of the on one, with the exception of you know, catfish and crappie, and then with you know, Panfish Weekly and Catfish Weekly, they have people on that they interview that a lot of us probably never heard of, which is something that's cool. You know, offer a totally different insight over something that we see from the same person every day. And when you hear the same interview over and over with the same person, it's kind of like, well, Kelly, I come into your live while you were driving before I went live. I didn't stay in there very long because I was getting set up over here. But what was your surprise? What were you picking up? What was your surprise? Prying ears or inquiring minds like to know. Oh, yeah, Jeremy. Like I've said before, it took drama for the whole unity thing, for all that unity thing to come out. Now, there was unity, with or without drama or before the drama. Yeah, that's why I like going to Mark. He often has a regular different person that a lot of us might have never heard of. Fishing different waters, doing different things. Ashley, what's going on, darling? How are you? Lori the Explorer. Sportsman boat. Awesome, Kelly. Did it come with a trolling motor or anything? I'm freezing up a little bit. Uh-oh. Yes, sir. Just why I stay out of the drama. I don't, you know. If I have something negative to say about anybody, I keep it to myself. I'm done with the whole throwing names out and being part of all that crap. Been drinking Wobble Pops most all day. I don't know what a Wobble Pop is. So to let you guys know, I did. That is all the line I ended up that broke off when I backlashed. But I did I'll wrap it around my hand. And before I ever do anything with it, unless I throw it in the burn barrel at home, I'll take scissors and I'll cut the loops. That way it's down into small pieces before I ever throw it if there's no line recycling place at the lake or anything, I cut it into small pieces before I throw it away. That way it's not in a loop or anything. Well, it can't get tangled up on wildlife or anything, so. Yeah. Let's say this one dude, not a good dude. Well, I appreciate it, NJ. I'm not a good dude. Right, Lori? Justin's fishing fetish. What's going on, Justin? How are you? Good. Been out fishing? Get her on any new PBs? You get any new PBs yourself? It does have a trolling motor with it. I only think I got to do is set up lights and put a ride on it. What? You got to set up lights and put a ride on it? I'm confused. We're up to 22 wonderful people in here watching these rods and watching the waves come in. Listen to me jibber jabber. Hell yeah, NJ, that'd be cool. I'm sure we definitely throw back some beers and do some fishing. We can even listen to some Shine Down. Oh, okay. I get the wobble pop thing there. Chris been on the beer today. Oh. Why are you not highlighting? Oh. Oh, yeah, beer. Right. I hear you, Jeremy. And you know, I do have my community tab. I have been bad about not sharing people out. And some of that just comes from laziness. You know, I go into the live, go into that person's live, and yeah. I get into talking and don't mess with sharing people out. Kelly got a Harley. Kelly'd fall over as soon as he took it off the kickstand. Wabash Nate in the house. We got Redneck, Kentucky Redneck Outdoors. Austin, what's going on, guys? At least it's a nice day out here. Waiting to take the kiddos out. So what are you going to take the kiddos out to do, Ashley? We've been going just over an hour. Might reel in and recast here shortly. I don't know if I'll rebait just yet. Right, Lori? Got that right. I hear you. And there are a lot of great people. A lot of great people. And, you know, I'll use the word community in the sense of the group of us, the large number of us that hang regularly in live streams and do live streams and everything. But there's a lot of people that have been around for as long as I've been around for the past year and a half or more, who are there day in, day out, day in, night out, and they don't ever get recognition. You see people give super chats, sending things to people. A lot of those people that do things like that, they don't get recognition that they deserve. There's a lot of people that just chat and don't go live, don't do videos. There are a lot of people that do deserve recognition. Sean T, what's going on? Yep. Yes, sir, Sean. You know, you won't see me over on TikTok. And I've actually left some lives from some of these guys that are trying to do dual YouTube and TikTok lives at the same time. I've left them just because, you know, what's the point coming on both platforms if you're only going to focus on one of them? Especially when that one that's not getting much attention is the one that got you where you're at, and the people there are the ones that got you where you're at. I'll still continue to be there and support, but sometimes it just, you know, gets to be a bit much. You kind of feel like you just left in a trail of dust. Going to outdoor mall, going to have Starbucks and eat. Sounds like a good time. Yeah. Yeah, it's just, you know, nope, damn hand. Yeah, NJ gets out there all the time. And I could, you know, I get off at, now I'm going into work at 7. And since they don't want to pay me overtime, the boss wants me to leave by about 3:30. So I do have plenty of time I can get out and fish. It's just a pain in the ass of having to drive anywhere. I'm down to have a taco eating contest. Hell yeah. Homemade tacos or store-bought? That's the difference. San Diego Astro Rod, what's going on? How are you? Now, if we're talking homemade tacos, I got some shells that I love. And when I use them, I can throw down some tacos like no other. Sounds good, Ashley. I hope you drive safe. Store-bought. Taco Bell soft. Oh, man. Why it gotta be soft tacos? Them damn tortillas are so filling. So filling and full of carbs. Hell yeah, homemade sounds great. Lori's on lunch break as we speak. Otter cat. Yeah. You know, you don't have to put out videos to be on YouTube. You know, I watched YouTube for years before I ever found live streams. And, you know, I wanted years ago when I was really making a lot of pieces, and I was able to do it after hours at work. I wanted to do a channel back then. Never did. But... finally got on here. Chris is proud of Miss Lori. Yep. Lori's getting by. I think Lori had a little bit of trouble with work a while back, but sounds like she's got a job that she's doing pretty good with. Hopefully enjoying it. Austin, it's kind of a good thing you don't drink. At least not in excess. I've been there when you had. I think you'd give Scott Swift a run for his money. I was giving Scott hell last night in Mike's fishing home. Poor Scott, he drinks and he gets to where you can't understand a word he says, but he'll still hang out up on camera. Good guy, and like him, enjoy. Yeah, Lori, I hear you. I'm playing catch up now, too. Trying to catch up, giving my son's mom money for him. Catch up on paying everything. And still trying to keep a little bit of money in the bank. NJ, you're crazy. All right, Lori, have a good day. Thanks for coming in and hanging out with us for a bit. Paul Boyd in the house. What's going on, Paul? They got tacos in San Diego. I've eaten lots there. Jeremy, you still a hoodlum. What are you talking about? I'm going to catch a 50-pounder today. I mean, wishful thinking and all, but... Oh. Yeah, you guys are going to get to see some bright white legs when I go to recast. I pull my shorts up since I didn't bring my swim shorts up Missouri with me. I think I'm going to do that next time. This is a nice lake. Hell, who knows? I may just come and do some swimming. All right, Chris. We'll be here. Yeah, hell, I'm still nursing the beer that I opened a little while ago. It's getting warm. NJ's wife going to Niagara Falls tomorrow. Should be home Monday. He may fish tomorrow night, too. 7 p.m. midnight. Anyone wants to hop aboard live if they fish. Sounds good, NJ. Remember that, everybody. If you're out fishing tomorrow night and NJ's fishing, he will put you up on panel and let you fish with him. Get you some exposure. Yep. Put them sunglasses on. You don't want to be seeing these white legs blinding you. Thank you, Jeremy. I appreciate it. Yeah. And who knows? Like I said, I might pack up, find me another spot. I might have YouTube auditor do a little searching or tell me another good spot he likes to fish or what might be a good area. I could have been on the other side of this point, but there was boats just lined up. They pulled up on shore and they were all hanging out in the water. The water might not be as rough. I don't know, but, you know, it is what it is. I found me a good shaded spot, area to get out. And you can't catch with baits not in the water, so I set up. I got after it. First one to open at 4:30. Well, yeah, I'm kind of more of a social drinker. When I'm out fishing, 2, maybe 3 beers at most if I'm by myself. Uh-oh, I put YouTube auditor on the spot. Now, he didn't put me on this spot. he had mentioned this, but I had already looked it up on Google Maps and looked around and found this spot, this area, and thought, who knows, it might be worth a damn to try. But I think I got those stupid little biting flies bugging me. If I stay out until dark, probably won't be much later. Now, I don't know. I might stay out a decent time. Because we're not going to be able to, me and the mechanic aren't going to be able to get in the job site until noon at least. Work on the crane. So, I can sleep in a little bit. I was supposed to be at work yesterday morning at 6 o'clock. And, my phone, I had it on, what did I have it on? I had it on whatever thing was going on. I think I had it on Jody's Flathead Challenge Thursday night. And didn't plug the phone in, so my phone died. I woke up at 4 o'clock in the morning and plugged it in, but I forgot to turn it on. So somehow, by the grace of God, I at least woke up at like, I woke up at 6:09. I made it to work by 6:30. May try up or down the bank. Yeah, who knows? I may try to find another spot over here, too. I don't know. Or if this fun boat traffic will stop or slow down. That might be helpful. Don't need the weirdos getting your spot. LNJ, you may enjoy doing you some night fishing. I mean, I love getting out at night fishing. Craig's Outdoor Adventures. What's going on, Craig? How are you? We're still chilling with 19 people in here. Lose tomorrow, though. I'm not fishing tomorrow night out of spite. Out of spite for what? I should have been up at like 5 o'clock this morning and headed down here, but man, it felt good to sleep in. I say sleep in. I mean, I slept till like 9. Well, I'm doing pretty good. The fishing ain't happening, or the catching part, but, you know. Yeah, I tend to do better with the late night fishing or the early morning. Only time I ever get the early morning is when I pull an all-nighter. All right, Randy. Thank you, sir. Thanks for coming in. Love you, brother. Give Tammy a hug for me. But I got a decent amount of bait that it's not going to hurt me to change out every now and then. I think I came with five bluegill, which one's small enough, I'm going to send it out whole. Just cut the tail off. But I got plenty of carp that I can cut and send out. Courtesy of Daniel45, he hooked me up with a couple 1-gallon Ziploc bags full of carp. Team Snagging Whiskers, what's going on, Dustin? How are you doing? Back up to 23 lovely people. Yeah, I think when I go to recast, I'm going to send Uncle Lou's rod out. Back out. Hopefully some bitch don't backlash on me. May tighten up the spool tension just a little bit. Man, I'm doing pretty good. I'm enjoying my day. I'd be doing a lot better if I could catch something or if I had any bites. I don't know if all these pleasure boaters are having an impact on that or not. I did not know the amount of boat traffic in this area when I drove down this way. Now, I won't be able to, when I move, I probably won't, if I move out of this whole area, I probably won't be able to do a ride-along move like I like to do. But I'll just show y'all what I had to deal with to get back here. When I have to end this one. Ow! Kim, all right. YouTube auditor, I appreciate the text. That might be something to check out. Now, it's pretty shallow out here from what I could tell. I mean, I don't even think it's 10 foot where I'm getting cast out to. It looks like Jamaica. All right, sounds good, Daniel. I did finally catch my first shad in a cast net last weekend when I was home. I went and fished at Little Axe. I went and fished the covered dock over there at Little Axe. And, man, the bluegill were thick as hell in the pit right there on the dock. So I was like, screw it. They weren't biting anything. Like, I guess they're jaded on bait. So I got the cast net. And that 3-foot cast net, it worked perfect for that pit. Only problem is I can't throw it worth a shit. But I did catch 2 bluegill and my very first shad. Well, I caught my very first bluegill. My very first anything in the throw net. But I caught 2 bluegill and 1 shad. So at least I know I can throw it good enough to at least catch a couple small fish here and there in it. Part of it was just the fact I was throwing in that small pit. I mean, that open pit in that covered dock is, what, about 6 foot wide and 25 foot long, something like that. Like even time in Jamaica, I'd love to go to Jamaica. Never been there. I've never been out of the country other than going to Mexico one day driving out. And I didn't even get to see anything cool. Yeah, Dustin, man, I was watching Jody's show the other night, a flathead challenge. Man, you were tearing it up. You did awesome that night. And happy late birthday to you. That was your birthday and you were catching fish. Yeah, Chris, it takes a little bit of work to get used to it. I think maybe about 2 out of 6 throws, 2 out of 5 throws, I can make it look like it, I can make it fan out and do okay. Yeah, I know you do, Daniel. I just never have done it. This is the one I'm throwing. I brought up here with me. It's one that Dominic was given when we went to Elgato's get-together down in Texas. Yeah, Dustin, I can imagine. Would have been nice to have your partner there, your buddy. But, you know, you did great, man. That was awesome. I think I got to see your 40, was it 42 or 46 pounds? That was a nice fish. All right. Warm beer down. Now, to give you guys a little overhead view of what I'm looking at, I mean, I don't know if a lot of you guys are around cypress trees ever. But they're pretty trees. But this is my view of up above. So I got good shade right here. Kind of surrounded by a canopy of trees. Got a few different types of trees. You're having matzo for dinner tonight, if anyone knows what that is. Have no clue, NJ. We're not all Italian. All right, Johnny. Appreciate you. Bourbon, cigar, and music time. Lucky man. All right. YouTube auditor sending me some texts on some more places that I can try. Had a phone conversation with him while I was headed, while I was trying to find a place to go. He's a pretty cool guy. There for a period of time, I kind of wondered about him. I was like, man, what is this? It's just a, it's like a troll name or something. But now he come around. He's a pretty cool guy. He's definitely been pretty helpful. Not Italian tonight. Oh, Daniel, I did that. I think after my last fishing live or something. Went in and added a few. NJ, when you gonna make me a mod? I might could make you a mod. Oh shoot. Phone's at 16%. Plug it in. Cool thing is I could start the truck if need be. I've got a 10-foot extension cord and I've got a 110 outlet in the truck that I could plug the cord into and I could use my rapid charger. But the Anchor brand battery pack that I have, it pretty much does a rapid charge. And it works great. It works faster than any of the other battery packs that I have because it does support the, it pretty much kind of supports the rapid charge like Samsung has. So if you're ever in the market for a battery pack, now Anchor brand is a little bit more expensive. I'm pissed at myself because I left my 30,000 milliamp that I bought last year. I had a 30,000 milliamp battery pack that I got on Amazon for $40. And I left it somewhere and never got it back. Now that same battery pack is like $60 or $65. So, but I will say, as opposed to any other brands that I've used, the Anchor, if you have a Samsung or any phone that supports the rapid charge, that Anchor brand will charge quicker than any others I've had. Oh yeah, Chris, it is. And the newer Chevys, Daniel's new Chevy, he's got a 2022 Silverado. It's got a plug. It's got an outlet in the bed, I do believe. And I think Fords come with a built-in inverter on some of them with plugs in the bed. Only problem with mine is I have to have the key turned on or I have to have the truck running to run the 110. Oh, damn. That's not good. Well, I got... The one I have is a 10,000 milliamp Anchor. And I've got a few others. I've got one of the On brands from Walmart. I think it's 8,000. And that'll hold. But I can run my phone, which is 4 years old with a fading battery. I can run it on that 10,000 milliamp for 6 hours at least. 6 to 7 hours. So, you know, if you're in the market, or you're in the need for a battery pack, Anchor brand, if you've got the extra money, spend it. you won't go wrong with it. Wife wasn't happy, I bet. Yeah, Chris, I screwed up and I bought, which I only bought a 100-watt inverter so I could plug it into the lighter socket. I meant to grab it and exchange it today at Walmart. What happened was when I went fishing with Elgato, when I took Dominic camping with him and Jackson, I tried running an air pump off of it, and that air pump draws too many watts, and I didn't think about it. So it doesn't want to work now. I don't know if it blew a fuse in it or what, but I'm not going to mess with it. I'm just going to take it back. Walmart will exchange it. But I need to get a higher wattage inverter. But I will plug it into the lighter and run off of that sometimes. So, like, in this situation, it would be perfect. I wouldn't have to waste my battery packs. Yeah, I was at 544 when I started today. I'm probably still there. Let me grab my cord and battery real quick. And I got some pretzel sticks to munch on. I got other things to munch on. I should have stopped and got something to eat before I came. I haven't eaten a thing today. All right, we're plugged in. In a few minutes, you have a 300-watt inverter, runs two lights in your phone. Awesome. Damn. Well, apparently I pissed some people off when I was talking about all the stuff I was talking about earlier. Oh, well. There's a lot of thin-skinned people on here. And another pontoon hauling ass close to it. J.D. Rivera, Lake Louisville, Texas. What's going on, J.D.? Yeah, I'd like to get me another, or, pretty big, because I took my lawnmower battery with me to use lights at camp at night, and be able to charge my phone and stuff, and I thought, well, my inverter, it'll work to run my 12-volt, I screwed up, I didn't buy the 12-volt air pump, which I should have, and I was at Walmart, and they had their 12-volt, 110 and their hand air pumps on clearance. So I bought the hand pump and the 110. And yeah, I totally forgot to take the hand pump. All right, Dustin, have a good one. Thanks for coming in and hanging out, buddy. Is it Guavera or Wavera? Probably kind of hard to tell me over typing, but But yeah, you're a new one. I appreciate you coming in. Always good seeing. Oh, no problem, Dustin. Always good having people in here. Good to have good people in. Now these waves calm down a little bit. I think I'm going to get out there and recast. Uh-oh. Oh, my phone's warm. Oh, it's charging. I just looked and it was at 10%. But then I looked back up and it said the U is silent. Govera? Okie dokie. Yeah, Kenneth, I had pocket juice before. Very first one battery pack I ever bought. I bought so I could take with me when I was out on the motorcycle. I'm going to wire up a lighter plug onto the bike sometime. All right, have a good one, JD. Thanks for coming in. Ottercat, thanks for coming in. Appreciate it. Can I pan out over across the lake left and right when I have time? Yeah. This water, this lake is really pretty blue water. This is my first time to ever come to Table Rock. It is a big lake, but the water, I mean, it is pretty. Yeah, if these waves calm down in a minute, I'll walk out, step out, and kind of pan around. Back to 21 people. Once again, thank you all for coming in and hanging out, being here. Even if you don't stick around, I appreciate you stopping in. And if you don't chat, I appreciate you stopping in, too. Eat another handful of pretzel sticks before hopefully these waves have calmed down and I'll go out there. Silver Dollar City. I see something across the way with a big old brass roof. Or like a copper roof. Water in a lot of places, Kenneth. Well, JD, you ought to. If you're contemplating about doing it, that means you want to. If you have the ability and you don't, then you're missing out. I can understand the heat. Because I know it's been hotter down there than it's been up here. CVA, I've already been thinking about doing that myself. I've got an idea for for a hitch-mounted rod holder, but it's not going to be just a plain stick in the hitch and not saying what you're making is going to be plain. All right. Come out of here and give you all a view. Got a view of the rods. You're not that creative. Now I'm only about 5 foot off the bank and I'm already mid shin, so it kind of drops off. But so got all these big old fancy houses across the street there. Wish I could zoom in. I don't think you can here. Nope. But big old fancy houses over there that I'd love to have, especially that big one right there to the left. Straight across the way, that's... Now, whatever that bright hotel is over there. Turquoise and purple hotel, or whatever it is. So that's where we're at. But there's whatever that water tower is. And who are you talking to, Chris? Me or Steven? I'll make mine for probably 3 to 4 rods. And I'm going to... When I get time, I'm going to modify these rod stakes to hold at least 2 rods apiece. Look for black rocks along the bank. That could be silver. Well, now you got me wanting to look for silver. Saw these jet skis coming by. And when I was at, I was up there at Sooner Lake last week, after Uncle Josh had left that spot that I was at, when I was about to be leaving, when I was in the truck cooling off, a guy showed up with a truck full of people, one jet ski, and he unloaded it. And I look, and it's only a 3-seater, but there were 4 people on it. 2 of them were small boys, and they all fit. But the way they were zooming across the lake wasn't very safe. But they got out. He had a tube he took out, so they were kind of alternating. So 3 on the jet ski and 1 on the tube. Oh yeah, you saw my Father's Day post with my Seether shirt. Yep, I got that several years back. Yeah, I got that shirt when I bought one of their CDs. Oh, the Words as Weapons CD. It came with the CD. Love that album. Yeah, I tried to find me an umbrella. I went to Walmart and Dollar General before I hit the road today. And Walmart had their like 7.5-foot umbrellas at a 6x7.5 rectangle a 7.5 and like a 9.5 foot. But they didn't have any kind of stakes or anything else. I was thinking, well, I just, you know, get me an umbrella. But they're more like the patio type. And in Academy, I forgot to look for umbrellas in Academy last night. And at Dollar General, they didn't have anything at all. Froggy's back. Well, I'm glad you made positive steps to make a little step forwards with four people. Glad to hear that, Froggy. Those thin-skinned people are in a lot of places. Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, they are, Kenneth. You know, it's like I disagree with a lot of people on here about their political beliefs or the way that they go, but I keep it to myself, especially even when people want to turn a fishing live into a political talk or make political comments, but I try to shrug them off. Try to keep that out of my streams. But you get a lot of thin-skinned people that way. Other obligations to call in. All right, Trail Dust. Sorry I couldn't bring in any fish for you, buddy. Indian Point to my left. Cove is Silver Dollar City. Froggy, I don't know if there's speed restrictions on here or not. Most lakes, most of the big lakes like this don't have, I mean, you could be out here in a jet boat doing 100. Well, I mean, I'm hoping for bites and all that stuff. I just sit back and I wait. There's a lost silver mine right in that area from back in the Bald Knobber days. Damn it. Maybe I need to go back. Maybe I need to go and be a silver miner while I'm here. Oh yeah, NJ's actually gotten a little more social with his chat since he first started. Alright, yeah, I'm going to recast. I'm going to pull that Zebco rod in, send my other Uncle Lou's rod out, put a fresh piece of bait on it, and probably go out and recast the others. Roll my shorts up. You guys see these old white legs? Do that in a minute, though. been something out there. There's been something out there because that was a good-sized body section. Good-sized body section of bluegill. And it's most of the way eaten up. Might have been gar. Might have been a turtle. Roll my shorts up real quick. All right, put your glasses on. I'm going to blind you. I think I got that cast into deeper water that time. Got damn tree branches right there. I'm about to check these two. Tree branch right there. Well, I'll keep that one low. Barely got any bait left on that one. That's been... It might be turtles, I don't know, because all that's left is skin. I'll send this baby bluegill out, minus the tail. Hung up on something. There we go. Got it loose. The pontoons out here navigating over these big old wakes. Oh. Well, that body section never got touched. Got Lake Patrol out there with his lights on. All right, I think I finally got cast out into some deeper water. Hi, we still got 16 people in here. Fisherman Sid, how you doing? Thanks for coming in. All right, we got all three rods rebaited. Got carp on. Got carp. Oh, I got. I think I got carp. No, I got bluegill on two of them. And I don't remember how. Either way, I got carp and bluegill out there. Laika, how you doing? Yes, my legs need tan. I told you. Put your glasses on. My legs are going to blind you. Yep. My legs will blind you. So will my belly. See, that's the problem with all these waves. You don't know if you're getting a bite or if it's the waves screwing with you. I can keep my hat on. Actually, I took my hat off when I got here. And I don't know if I've ever actually watched the pool, Monty. You'd sling 8-ounce pyramid sinkers at those clowns in the boat. Yeah, see, they come in close and they don't care. Now, if you're in a boat, a lot of times, you know, you don't see a fisherman tucked back like I am, you know, that's one thing. But if you actually see people fishing, yeah. Fish out a baby shark. I'm going to try to fish something out. I'm not going to scroll back as far as I missed, but hey, small water, John in the house, what's going on? All right. My belly's fine. Well, thank you, Laika. Yeah, Robin C. Robin C., you're a new one for me. Thanks for coming in. But yeah, it's a pretty spot. Like I said before, for anybody that wasn't in here, this is a, yeah, that's what I'm saying, Daniel. They can't see me. So I did have some slowdown earlier when they saw me. And there was actually a pontoon about to drop anchor and they were going to hang out over here. But then they saw me back here fishing. But this, I'm out on a point, and this used to be a campground, and it's run down, shut down, probably shut it down because of flooding. That's the only thing I can see. But the roads, you know, the paved roads are still, for the most part, in here. But the trees are overgrown. Wrapped my truck up some, coming through, stopped and broke some limbs off. You lost 29 pounds in 5 months. Well, when me and my ex split up, when me and Dom's mom split up, I lost, I think, like 25 pounds in a couple months or a few months. Now, granted, that, you know, 2 months after that happened, I lost my mom. And 2 weeks after that, I lost my grandma. So, yeah, I wasn't eating much of anything at all for a long period of time. So, I saw 195 for the first time in years. Hey, NJ, if you have Netflix, now, granted, it's Zac Efron. You know, Zac Efron's a pretty cool dude to me. But he did a show on for Netflix. It's called Down to Earth. And there's an episode where he went to Italy and he went to the part, an area in Italy they call, I think it's a blue zone. And blue zones, thank you, Laika. That's part of life and all that. It's got to move forward. But blue zones are where you have a number of centenarians, I think is what they call them, 100-plus-year-old people. But blue zones are where you have big groups of them. And there's an area there that he went to in Italy that I can't remember how many people in that cemetery were over 100 years old. Now, in the United States, they preach, you know, if you want to lose body fat, you want to build muscle, yada, yada, yada. They preach low carbs, high protein. But over there in Italy, you got all these people that are super skinny, 100 years old, and they eat high carbs and low protein every day. Now, that's crazy. Yeah, MJ, it's actually a pretty good series. I can't remember how many episodes there are. I think there's like seven or eight. It's a really cool show. He goes all around the world and does different things. But that episode where they're talking there in Italy was really neat. But yeah, Italians, you see a lot of Italians, they're skinny and they eat high carb, low protein. It's crazy. But it works. Works for them anyways. There's an episode where they go to Iceland and they're talking about, they're showing how you can actually cook your eggs, you can cook your breakfast. All you got to do is dig a hole in the ground and you cook your breakfast in the ground because the ground is so hot there. And that's how they heat most of the country, geothermal heat from the ground. Right, Laika? That's a good problem to have. I used to be that way until I was in my early 20s. It took me, I was 155 pounds all the way through high school. Got out of high school, it took a couple of years for me to get to 175. And then I went through a big depression, got down to like 153. And then got on medicine, got on Lexapro. And within like 4 months, I was up to like 195, and I haven't seen the 180s since. It sucks. I want to get rid of my belly. My man boobs. Need to work out, and I need to change my diet. I need to get me a little propane grill for the room. I'll cook a lot more with that. Just a pain in the ass, using the electric skillet, hot plate. Yeah. It don't take long, but man, I'll tell you, you know, it helped me at that point in time. It helped me get my head straight. Helped me get my diet straight, too. Just got my body in a place where I didn't want it. And it ain't gone back. Your mom had 8 kids? Good Lord. My dad's one of 8 kids. My sister-in-law, I don't know, she's from Indonesia, and she's the baby of the family, and I don't know how many siblings she had, but when we turned 30, she's a few months older than me, like 4 months older, I think. When we were turning 30, her dad was just about to be turning 90. So yeah, he was going for a while. Time was at about 4:15 when I switched out all the baits. We've been going for 2 hours and 10 minutes. We got 12 people in here. Got a lovely crowd. I appreciate everybody for hanging out with me. As always, you're not expected to stay. You got things to do. I understand that. There's other lives to check out. But hey, you don't want to check them out or you just want to hang out, that's perfectly fine. I love this. Love the socializing. I love the people coming in and being here. Gabapentin. Damn. Yeah, get on medicine like that. That's why I told I have eczema. And what's the steroid? I can't think of the steroid I was on. But I was on it for a long time. Now, if you stay on steroids for a long time, that can cause problems with your kidneys and other organs. So, between that and the weight gain, I told my dermatologist, oh, metal rod. Like it was doing something, and I don't think it was waves. But I told my dermatologist, I said, I need to get off these steroids. That I need something different. Hey, me neither, Laika. This is my life anymore. You know, I'm working out of town in a city that I don't know. Only got one friend in town, and he's always busy. That's Sunfish King. We're going to get together and do some fishing sometime, though. But, yeah. This is my social life. Now, I did go out to dinner with a coworker for my birthday. But, hell, he spent most of his time on his phone. So, I ended up talking to a couple that was sitting next to me, and they live in Alaska. He's in the Coast Guard and getting stationed in Maine. And they've got family in Missouri and Texas, so they're going and seeing both their families. But, yeah, they're a pretty good couple to talk to. It was nice. Went out and had Japanese food, hibachi, and some sushi. It was yummy. Wasn't enough there, though. Had me a Sapporo. I'd had a couple of Sapporos, but I was buying my own birthday dinner. And they were like $7.45 a piece. Well, I'm sure there's something you can find that you can have a little bit of entertainment in your life that doesn't involve partying and drinking. Not everybody drinks. Don't have to drink to have a good time. Sometimes it helps. These flies are really driving me crazy. I think I'll give it another hour. If I don't catch anything, I might find somewhere different set up. As much as I love to fish and get out and fish, and I'd love to have me a boat that I can get out and fish on, I really would love to have me a good pleasure boat. Get out and have fun. That's something I think Dominic really, I want to be able to do for him when he starts getting a little bit older. Because growing up as a little kid, I loved getting out on the boat, going out on the tube, just having fun. Your boy's taught himself Japanese, and he has matcha tea ceremony every night. Well, that's interesting, Froggy. If it ain't cooked, you ain't eating it. Well, I mean, pretty much everything we eat in the way of sushi, it's been flash frozen. But now there are cooked and fried sushi rolls. They're really yummy. I've had some good ones. You're the only one with a real job like it. Hey, welcome back, Randy. Yep, sushi's awesome. Nope, no fish. I just rebaited and recast about 10 minutes ago. I stepped out a little bit further into the water this time and got better casts. I noticed the weights. I noticed they did drop. I did have more line pull once they hit the water. I think I'm a little bit deeper, so that could change possibilities. I'm not, you know, I like eel sushi, but we tried the sashimi one time with just, you know, the ball of rice with the meat over it. And the sushi just wasn't my favorite. Miso soup is awesome. I must be ultra bored all by myself there. Brother goes fishing with your monkey. To upload a video of your monkey who's now 22 years old. Helps your brother fish by grabbing the net. That's awesome. I want a pet monkey. Man, a ginger dressing salad sounds really good right now. What is my favorite fish for sushi? Ah, shoot. I like tuna. I like tuna and shrimp. Uh-oh. My phone's starting to get hot. It's blinking. That's crazy. You know, switch over here away from the sun. Maybe that'll help. Give you guys a different view, too. Maybe that little bit of sun shining on it was making it a little bit hot. We'll see. Octopus. I don't know if I've had octopus sushi. I'm not sure. Hold on, guys. I'll be right back. Now, Jeremy, there is something out there. Might be turtles, might be, I don't even think it's gar. But when I reeled two of them in, I had nothing but small piece of bluegill left on one hook and the skin of the carp left on another. Yeah, my phone's deciding it wants to get hot. Well, glad you were able to get a good monkey to be a pet. Like, what kind of monkey is it? Take the case off this phone. Maybe that'll help to get it a little air. Sorry, guys. Ooh, yeah, this thing is hot. There we go. All right, come on. Come on, phone, cool off. You only have the long-tailed macaque and the suicide monkeys. I'm not familiar with the suicide monkey. I'll have to look those up. I know what the macaques are, though. Aren't those the monkeys that are kind of buttholes? Throw their poop on you and everything? Well, moving spots and taking the cover off my phone has caused my phone to stop blinking the red light and the battery bar to stop blinking. So I think it's starting to cool off a little bit. Yeah. Sounds like you guys had a little issue. Can't we all just get along? Glad you're getting along today just fine, though. Yeah, if I'd have brought another pair of shorts with me, I don't even care if they'd be swim shorts. I can get out there and go swimming for a few minutes. Let you guys hang out, and I go cool off in the water. I'm really not all that hot. A little light sweat. Down to 9 people. That's all right. People are surging in and out. I could camp back here listening to this water, though. But at night, I'm sure the water isn't rolling in like this without all the boats. If they hear noise, they commit suicide. Wow. Oh, wow. Wears diapers at 22 years old. That's crazy. That's cool, though. Yeah, you'll have to get a video of your monkey. I want to see it. Oh, yeah, what I was talking about, this being an old rundown campsite, campgrounds, right there on the ground next to the tree, that's the concrete and part of probably the bench of one of the picnic tables laying right there next to the tree. You're starving? Yeah, me too. You're 34 and you wear diapers. That's scary. I wore an adult diaper once for Halloween. Y'all remember the Mountain Dew? What are the Mountain Dew energy drinks? But they had that, their little mascot, Puppy Monkey Baby. Yeah, I dressed up as Puppy Monkey Baby once. It's pretty funny. It was hilarious. Wonder if I can share that picture. I think I still got it on this phone. I don't know how you share anything. Let's see. Yeah, I need Mike or Becca to show me how to share things. I don't know if you can do it from your phone or not. You can do it on a laptop. But yep, I was Puppy Monkey Baby for Halloween. I carried around the bucket of the Mountain Dew drinks and everything. Come on, Pole. Boat traffic has kind of tapered off over here a little bit. Let's get a fish. I know people like listening to me talk, but I also want to see fish. Stick to short shorts. That's funny. I even wore hose and everything. Aw, NJ and Leica are hugging and making up. How about that? See, there are adults. Yeah, she just throws out the fancy things trying to get my attention. I'm simple. I don't need all the fancy things to get my attention. That damn flies. For a minute, I thought those two further boats away were connected. Four to five houses to the left of that big one across the lake. We rebuilt it down by the lake, and they wouldn't even let me go. What the hell? Really? Wow. Now that's some bull right there. Yeah, Jeremy. This is definitely not the area for fishing, apparently. I mean, you know, a weekend in the 90s, yeah, everybody's going to be out on the water. They want to get out there and get wet and go play. We had a freak storm come through the other day at work. Couldn't believe that. I think it was Thursday afternoon. That was crazy. Came in fast and with a vengeance. I'm sitting there in the crane flying stuff up. And next thing I know, I'm getting wind gusts coming up to over 30 miles an hour. That. Oh, like it. You ain't been shut down. You ain't been shut down. I just been reserved. Yep, I almost busted my face on that one. Those little cypress nubs or whatever you call them. Yep. Oh damn, I'm sorry to hear that, Lika. That's not good. I don't know what I'd do if I lost everything to a tornado in Oklahoma. Now, so many keepsakes and stuff, sentimental things, you know. You can always buy things again, but you know, there's some things that can't be replaced. Once they're gone, they're gone. Robert Johnson, what's going on, man? Yeah, it's a pretty view, isn't it? Glad you're getting to enjoy the view and hang out. Man, my fingernails, they're not bad yet, but I left my clippers at home. And since I didn't go home this weekend, yeah, I'm needing them. I'm gonna clip my fingernails, it drives me crazy. Now, these waves drive me crazy. You know, I had something tearing apart my bait, but never knew it. That might be what's happening right now and not the waves. But it's not any kind of tugs or pulls, so I can't really tell. Back to 17 wonderful people. That's part of why I set up here and didn't search for another spot down the way that was more open. Because this is, I mean, with all the shade and just with the pretty trees and everything, the nice view. Like, I'll sacrifice something just to have a nice view. Every time I look out at the rods, that sun, the sun's not in my eyes, but there's enough glare that looking back down at my phone, it's messing with my eyes. It takes me a second to readjust. Like, yeah. Come on, fishy, 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 fishy. Need Becca in here to do a fishy song for me. Maybe that'll bring on a fish. Uh-oh. Why'd you interview for 6 different airlines? You don't like the one you're working for now? I don't know which one you work for. Hopefully you end up with one that you're happy with. Yeah, Daniel, it is. This is my first time to ever see it up close, other than when we brought the kids to Branson back in 2019. We brought the older two and spent several days here in Branson. And we only ended up driving, I don't know, we were in Branson driving around, and we could see part of the lake from where we were, and that's the only time, that's the closest I've been to it. But man, driving it, the drive around it is freaking amazing, because there's so many places you're way uphill and looking down on everything. There's one spot I wish I'd have stopped and taken a picture, but it was off of a 2-lane road and there wasn't really a stopping spot. But it was looking downhill at the lake, and I mean, it was just an amazing view. And that would have been a nice thumbnail picture to have. $4.50. No fishy. $4.50 and no fishy. Eugene, what's going on, sir? Yeah, it's a beautiful spot. I should take the Bigfoot tour. I don't know. I'll be up here for a while, and like I found today, it's a little bit closer to get to Branson, a little bit quicker getting to Branson than Google Maps says. Now, they base theirs off of speed limits and everything, which anybody that's ever ridden with me or anybody that knows me knows I don't drive a speed limit. Time for last visit to Miranda Veranda after 4 a.m. Woke up and heading for 11 p.m. here. Worked for Philippine Airlines, been there 9 years. Fluent multiple languages, other airlines, look for that. From Delta, American Airlines, or Canada, and WestJet. Awesome. Well, Air Canada, no. Well, make sure you get a raise. I mean, I wouldn't switch positions unless I was making more money. They might fly more places, I don't know. That'd be pretty cool, though. And just to let y'all know, I am drinking water, too. Staying hydrated in the heat. Well, that's awesome. I like it. Well, I only have one parent, but my dad would like to fly somewhere. Him and mom talked about traveling the world. Took my dad retiring to finally try to enjoy life. That sucks, but, you know, they finally started doing things. He gets out and does things now. Traveling would be something that'd be great. There's a lot of the world I've always wanted to see. Come on. Relentless. Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. Double the salary. And they pay you while you're sleeping? Can't beat that. I guess that's almost kind of like paying kind of like a per diem, I guess. Fishing the dream. What's going on, George Ray? How you doing, sir? No fish to speak of, just a lot of good conversation. And pretty sights. Grab my glasses, maybe that'll help my eyes adjust. And, oh, geez, I can't even see the phone screen. I gotta squint. They pay for you being in my chat. Can't beat that. Hell, I get paid while I'm in NJ's chat and other people's chat too. But that's because I'm in there while I'm actually working. Now, if I am chatting, I'm not actually running the controls, just to let y'all know. Well, quite a bit in the Army. Oh, you've traveled quite a bit in the Army. I've seen some nice places as well. Crap holes. You stay as you like the good old United States. Yeah. I want to go to Switzerland, Sweden, places like that in Europe. I want to go to Poland. No, I'm Polish. Now this is the fishing boat I'd like to have right there. Check that thing out. Got the deck on the front. Man, I'd put rod holders all around that front. Be set up. Oh, yeah. That's a good setup right there. I don't care who you are. Ended up being the real Jack Nicholson. That's crazy. Oh, yeah, Daniel, I watch while I'm working. I'm just not actually chatting while I'm at the controls. If I'm chatting, I'm not actually picking anything, or I might be hooked up to something, you know, a form. I might be waiting while they're filling a concrete bucket or something, but. Well, there are other lakes around here. There's Bull Shoals, and there's Taney Como. They're all, I guess, in the same lake system that I eventually plan on hitting. You've been to Warsaw, Poland? Now, I'm Polish. I'd like to go see where my family came from. I think it was my great-grandparents that came over. I can't quite remember. I think I remember my dad telling me that growing up, when his dad was growing up on the farm, if he didn't speak Polish, he got his hands swatted with a ruler or something. Mine in Poland that has been carved into a cathedral, and I think it said they said it'll fit up to like 3,000 people. Monica, hey girl, hey. What's up, Monica? Thank you, darling. I appreciate the birthday wishes. Yeah. About 30 more minutes, I'll probably reel them in and go find another spot to go to. End this live and start another one. Although no fish, pretty scenery and just listening to the water coming in is nice. What's up, Brand? How you doing? Yeah, Monica, it's beautiful here. And it's hot. It's 97 degrees. But I'm under a canopy of the trees, so it's not really affecting me very bad. Got a breeze. Got the water. Got 18 people in here. Used to go fishing every day before we worked in school. Awesome. One of these days, I'm going to find a catfish in Missouri. Even if I got to rent a boat. Just got back from fishing. About the storm. Hurricane season. Yeah, I'm doing all right. Yeah, Monica, I'm going to be here for a few more months still. So I got plenty of time. As you can see, for those of you just joining, there is a lot of boat activity. The pontoons that have been coming really close. Ow! Pontoons that were coming really close. They've kind of not been coming so close anymore. Good thing. You'll be back. All right, Eugene. Be safe. Don't work too hard. I didn't really have anywhere to go fishing back during high school. I mean, I did, but didn't. I don't think I ever skipped to go fishing. Yep, some people call it misery. Next spot, choose a less stumpy area. Well, yeah. I didn't really plan on choosing the stumpy area to begin with, but that's what happened. Maybe I'll be able to find a cove or something where there's not a lot of boat activity, the water's not real rough. Because all you see, all the water movement, I mean, that's from the boats. There's a breeze, but there's no wind. Not enough wind to make the lake rough. Yeah, Brant, that's good. Relax in the cool air. Cool off after being out there in the sun and the heat. Yeah, I tripped on one. Because I got these cypress trees right here. And I got the little stubs. Little nubs or whatever you call them. Sticking up. I never either possible this year. And most of them haven't caught any fish yet. I haven't caught a catfish in probably the last eight trips out. Something like that. Probably more. Nice, NJ. 7-foot shark. Tail cut your line. That sucks. You'd trip on the wave. Dude going by in a fishing boat with it looked like a just like a pool raft or something tied up the back of it. That was a decade ago. Y'all see that big old gar that Danny Stone caught the other night? That thing had to be 4 and 5 foot long. Well, that thing whip around. Its mouth was probably 14 inches long. All those teeth. Woo! Cypress knees. Yeah, that sounds about right. Waves here enough for you. I get in a position where I catch a guard. Monica, I'm in South Missouri, down by Arkansas at table. Oh, fish! Let go. Sitting there watching it pull. My phone might be getting hot. Again, I don't know. Am I back? Am I back again? Sir, it's been blurry the whole time? What the hell? I've got full bars. Why don't you change your setting to 720? You got it on 720? Your video quality? Right, NJ? I'd like to catch something. Been here for 3 hours. Almost had baits in water almost three and a half hours. Finally get a noticeable bite. That Uncle Lou's rod was pulling. I love beaches and oceans. Buffering. Well, I don't know what's going on with it. So I got full bars here. Awesome. All right, now can you see it? Maybe. Maybe not. There we go. Now we can see all three. Ah. Oh, see if that helps anything. No, my phone sure is hot. Campers in Common, Mel, how are you? Thank you for coming in. Tina Ladybug, what's going on? Danny keeps saying they're a rare turtle. Really not. I mean, in where he's at in Missouri, they might be. But, I mean, they're really not that rare. I remember looking up before, and when he was talking about it, I not injured, but there are states that they're banned and illegal to handle them. Banned from collecting or taking for meat or anything. My brother about had his thumb bitten off by one when we were younger. He was trying to feed it grass, and, well, it tried to feed on him. Welcome back, Ashley. Ricky. What's going on, Ricky? No problem, Froggy. Thanks for coming and hanging out. Have a good one. Have a good evening. Well, shoot, evening. It's 11:15 at night there. I mean, you shouldn't have sat on your thumb. Nah. Man, I finally got a bite. That's got me. Hold out and hope for it to come up. Think I'm gonna have to go up on shark fishing cat, and I have seen some monsters this week. Awesome, Billy. Yeah. What's the count? One bite. Bum in the bum, Ashley says. These flies are really driving me crazy, and they're only messing with my freaking legs and you know what it do. Oh, Buffeye. Only be a few more minutes, and I'm going to pack up, move location. I'll probably end the stream. I'll let y'all see what I had to go through just to get back here. If I can remember how to get out. I think I can. Jeremy, welcome back. No fish yet. I finally got a bite. And there's a guy. Oh. It was right. Oh. Let's see if moving any will help. A little bit. That help anything? Am I back? If Daniel's back. Sitting right next to the big old tree. Anybody? Put you up on the tailgate. Now, any better? Feel bad? Yep, the tailgate. Yeah, my phone's pretty damn hot. It still says it's 97 degrees out here. Start getting my stuff ready to go to the next spot. Wherever that might be. Campers in common with Mel, where do you live? You got storms blowing in. Thank you. I hope I catch one at least. I don't know where the next spot I'm going to stop at is going to be. It might be a half-hour drive. Might not even take that. Might not take that long to get to. I'm not sure. Oh. Eastern New Mexico. I got you. Well, hopefully you're safe in the storms. Glad it looks better. Hope it sounds better. Now the only thing to make it better is catch fish. I'd really, really like to catch fish. Kind of like on that movie National Treasure with Nicolas Cage. The end where he's like, I'd really like to not go to jail. Well, Ben, somebody's going to have to go to jail. Somebody's going to have to catch fish. Might not be me. Jonathan B., what's going on, John? That's my brother right there. That's my brother, John. All right, Leica, thanks for coming in. Definitely loved having you in here. It's been a pleasure. Come back later on the next segment if you're able. Good Lord. People just all over the place. Don't have any boating etiquette. Oh, Uncle Lou's rod just did something. Oh, rolled over. It rolled over. I was hoping it was a bite, but nope. All right, Mel, take it easy. YouTube auditor. YouTube auditor is like my Missouri tour guide. I'm gonna put a couple things in the truck. Had a woman telling me last night while I was at Texas Roadhouse. She's like, oh no, you don't want to go there. You don't want to go to Table Rock. You want to go here. Well, I want to go to Table Rock. I can try the other spots another time, but I'm going to go to Table Rock tomorrow. Nah. Thank you, Laika. Hopefully I catch something. What's up, Brian B? Putting in the work. Only got one bite. About to pack up and move to another spot. Start another stream after I get moved. One good pull. Had one good pull on Uncle Lou's rod, and when I got to it, blah, he let go as soon as I got there. Could have been a turtle for all I know. The way I reeled in a couple of those rods, and there was nothing left but carp skin on one, and a small piece of bluegill body on the other. Yeah, they were. It was probably a turtle down there munching away. All right, Daniel. Might do that. I'm on fishy. You get one before I finish packing up. I catch another damn turtle, I'm gonna be pissed. BC 69 65 925. What's going on, BC? How's it going? I think your name's Bill, maybe Bob. Not quite sure. Ernie Brown, what's up, sir? Thank you for coming back. I noticed you were in here earlier. I'm just getting things ready to go to another spot, wherever that might be. Not quite sure, but we'll find somewhere else to go. All right, Ricky, take it easy. Be safe. For those of you that didn't see it, Mr. Ricky finally got on camera on Hog Legs the other night. And Hog Leg did his everybody make a BLT and eat it on camera thing. Trying to recover from heat yesterday, yeah. The heat will get you, especially in your older ages. You're not old yet, Ernie, but you're older. Oh, reel them in. One at a time. Well, got to reel them in one at a time. Anyway, what's up, Chad? About to move locations. Well, I still had all my bait. What's up, Mike Irvin? Alrighty. Oh, shoot, though. Almost forgot my steaks. Alright. Where's them set? Stupid flies. Give you guys a little ride along. I had to get in here. Yeah, I know. Change oil soon. Roll the window up, get the air going. Can y'all hear me? Ooh, this phone is getting hot. If I put it in reverse. Somebody let me know if you can hear me. Try this. All right. There we go. Now I got it going through the Bluetooth. Not that that matters, because there's nobody else to hear. But yeah, this is... I was saying an old campground. You see, like, the old decrepit picnic tables. YouTube auditor said it's been closed for a long time. I hope this is the way I came. It's kind of a maze getting through here. Oh, scratched the truck up. And I don't remember being on this road coming in. Might have to find a different path. Actually, I think this is the road I came in on. Because there was a Jeep or Dodge Nitro set up over here. Yeah, the majority of the paved road's still here. Like, they've got stuff dumped in the road that actually comes in here, blocking the road. And that's the way it came in. That was the rough way. Let's see if this way. See if I can. Oh, shoot. Let's see. Now, that's not too bad of a drop off. I think. Yeah. See, they got the road blocked off up there. Don't tell me. Oh. Yeah, this is... I think I can make that without tearing off my running boards. We'll find out in a second. All right. Yay. Oh. Okay. Well, that wasn't as bad as getting in here. But they still have a boat ramp here. Yes, I know my seatbelt's not on. Like, there's a boat ramp. No. Anyways, all right, guys. I'm going to go find another spot. All the big fish are right there. Well, all right, where? We'll find another spot. Let my phone cool off a little while. But I'll come back up and I'll go live again here after a while. So I want to thank everybody for coming in. Love y'all. Appreciate it. But yeah, I will be back after a bit and hopefully we can find a spot where we can get fish. Until then, I will talk to y'all later.